In this video on Skull and Bones, we're going to be talking about how to get the best ship armor, or at least one of the best ones, the highest quality ones that you can currently get. And it's actually kind of easy to get, to the point where I actually already have three of them. If I go ahead and I go manage my ship, you can see my ship right now is a solid rank 7. It's a rank 7, right? That's just my weapons and my furniture. But if you see, I don't have any armor equipped, and this makes a massive difference. This is actually how people have been reaching the maximum rank that we have right now, which is 11. So if I go ahead and I put this Royal Custodian armor, which you can see has 400, it's got 24% resistance against explosions, 12% against drowning, 12% against fire, and 30% against piercing types of attacks. All right, if I go ahead and put this on, boom. What rank do you think the ship is now? If I go ahead and I back out here, it's rank 11. It's the maximum rank. So you can see here, I have three of these ship armors, and honestly, I got them all doing the same exact thing. So I assume you guys could do the same exact thing and have a very high chance of getting one, if not multiple of these too. And the way to do this is actually through the legendary heist feature. So this is after you have unlocked the helm. So this area, if I hold C, and you get to the helm, after you've like unlocked all of this and you've done all the things here, you'll have to finish the quest line for the helm to unlock this. And once you have this, you actually unlock a table, and you don't have to use the table. You can actually just open up your map, and you can click this icon over here for the helm at any point, no matter where you are on the map. Open it up, and you can see here, you can track your whole thing. So I have pretty much every single location in the Red Isles right now as of a little bit earlier on, but you'll see there are takeover opportunities that happen every 30 minutes. Alongside this, there is a chance that you get a legendary heist, and it's to unlock one of these locations. But when you do get a legendary heist, it's going to be a blue quest. It's going to look like this on your screen, and it will happen for, it's basically the PvE, the safe version of a hostile takeover. So instead of having to fight other players for a location or a manufacturing location from one of the, you know, the outposts on the world, it will quite simply let you just, you know, start the event. You'll do the legendary heist, which entails you hunting down a specific ship that has a yellow rimmed health bar. You don't have to fight the other ships. You can if you want. However, you'll notice that I completely ignored them, and I just went straight for the one with the yellow health, because as soon as you sink that one, a special, you know, thing will drop that you need to pick up, and whoever in your group, only three people are able to join in this event, but you can still do it as a solo player too. As long as you sink that ship, whoever picks up the item has to deliver it to the nearest den in order to cash the, you know, event in. And once they've done so and they've like gone into the den, everybody in the group will unlock the outpost that it was for. But if you're lucky, you will also get the Royal Custodian armor, which is the item for your ship, after you defeat this enemy, like, you know, the yellow health enemy. Once you defeat them, they have a chance of dropping this armor, and that is where I have gotten it three times in a row, essentially. Like, I've gotten it like three times every single time. The last three times I did it, I got that armor every single time, regardless if I was the first person to loot or even the second person to loot, because the first person always gets the item to go to the den. The second person has to just like escort them and make sure nobody sinks them until they get to the den. And then all you have to do is head back to your ship by pressing the Z key, the anchor key at the bottom right, and then going into manage ship, change your armor, and equip that bad boy, and your rank will go skyrocketing. Like from 7 to 11 with one single item. It's that good. Just beware, the higher your rank is, the higher the rank of the rogue ships that hunt you down. I generally like to actually fight them at level 10 rather than level 11, because at level 11 they're a little bit harder, and sometimes it's hard to fight four of them at once without sinking. So just be aware that when your rank increases, so do the ranks of the enemies who hunt you down in the helm quest. So beware of that. But I hope you guys found this video helpful. I will be talking about ship builds in my next videos. I'm going to be using the Brigantine as well as the Snow Ship, which is surprisingly better than I thought it would be. So stay tuned for that, and I'll catch you around. Thanks for watching.